By God's gift and call, all of us who have been baptized into Christ Jesus are daily put to death, so that we might be raised daily to newness of life. Let us sing the hymn 618, the whole congregation, guide me ever, great Redeemer. Rise, please. I greet you on this Pentecost Sunday with the theme of the day, but you will receive power when the Holy Spirit has come upon you, and you will be my witness in Jerusalem, in all Judea, and on Samaria, and to the end of the earth. Acts chapter 1. Today, we special greet the confirmants and their family, confirmants 2014-2015, are Saxon Delilah Petra Hoffman, Kevin Christopher Cronin, Braddon Gregory Schultz, and Garrett Thomas Schultz. This celebration of confirmation is also a sign of a new beginning in our congregation. I would like to welcome all visitors who are here because the confirmation. I invite you all to participate on the Holy Communion during the service today. We have a place in our table for all people, all religions, no problem. It is a pleasure to receive you in our house. I also would like to thank Mike, I don't know if he's here. Mike Harmon from Mount Zion Church for teaching during the last year, the confirmation class in this year. I thank you so much that he did this. We thank the families of the confirmation group. They has donated the flowers for our altar. Thank you so much. I appreciate what you are doing. We are looking for youth who were born in the year 2003. Youth born in earlier years are also welcome. to register your youth for the 2-year confirmation course, which is starting in September 12th, it is important to contact the church office. And I appreciate that we have the confirmants from the second year here, the colleagues from the confirmation group. This is Rebecca, Simon, and Kurt Andrew. Welcome to our church today, and the solidarity for our small group here, 4 confirmants. Important for the congregation is the next Sunday too, the May 31st, after the German service at 10:30, we will have a special congregational meeting in our church here to discuss the replacement of the flat roof here over our hall and all the office roof. And the coffee hour for the German congregation will follow this very important meeting. So next Sunday we want to discuss about this. And for our congregation, the annual picnic has been set on Sunday, the June 28th, at Capilano Park. The German service will be here in our church at 9:30, as it is in all Sundays. And the English service will be at the picnic site at 11:30, with the picnic to follow at 12:30, and all are invited. If somebody want to help to organize this picnic, please talk with our office or Linda or Rose de Souza. The quilting is in need of some extra special support, and a way in which everybody can get involved is putting your name on a list, and you will be eligible to win one of 2 quilts that the group will give away for this purpose. With these funds, they will be able to purchase more material and sew more quilts for the needy people overseas. We will know the will. We know who will be the owners of the 2 quilts today after the English service. So, if somebody wants to help, talk with Gertrude or with Irene. We would like to thank everybody who gave so generously to this relief effort for the earthquake relief, Nepal earthquake. We, in the last 3 weeks, we received $2,485, which the Canadian government will match. So it's appreciate what our congregation members did. I thank you so much for our choir. They are singing during this service, as it is in the German too. It was in the German too. And we thank you for choir and for Michael. They organized this, and special solo Christian Maxfield. And I will explain later about the music or about the hymn during the readings. So let us sing the hymn 405, A Spirit of Life, 405 in the Red Book. Thank you. We begin this service in the name of God, the Father, of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Before the world was created, the world already existed.
He was with God, and He was the same as God.
The Word became human and lived among us.
We saw His glory, full of grace and truth.
In this moment, we wish to ask God that He may forgive us all our sins in the name of His Son, Jesus Christ. Lord God, You created the world and made us in Your own image. Forgive us when we turn away from You.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord God, through Your Son, You overcame evil and death. Rescue us from sin's slavery.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord God, by Your Spirit, You restore us to fellowship with You and with one another. Breathe Your love and freedom in our lives.
Lord, have mercy.
Do you trust in God's compassion and believe in God's love and redeeming power for yourself and your neighbor?
I do.
Then I declare to you God's forgiveness of all your sins. God's power to guide you on your journey to life everlasting, and God's love to accompany you always. In God's name, I declare to you that you are God's children, sisters and brothers in Christ, inheritors with Him of God's kingdom.
Thanks be to God.
Let us pray all together the prayer of the day as it is in the insert. Mighty God,
You bring light into our problems, and Your Spirit brings truth into the world. Send us this Spirit, transform us by Your word, and give us language to proclaim Your gospel. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, who lives and reigns with You and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
Please be seated. Let us hear the readings. I invite Mike to read the readings as a former teacher from this group. Thank you that you came. You read the readings from Romans and the Psalm. And the Psalm is responsively.
Change that. We are reading from Romans 8, 22 to 27. We know that the whole creation has been groaning in labor pains until now. And not only the creation, but we ourselves, who have the first fruits of the Spirit, groan inwardly while we wait for adoption, the redemption of our bodies. For in hope we are saved. Now hope that is seen is not hope. For who hopes for what is seen? But if we hope for what we do not see, we wait for it with patience. Likewise, the Spirit helps us in our weakness, for we do not know how to pray as we ought. But that very Spirit intercedes with sighs too deep for words. And God, who searches the heart, knows what is the mind of the Spirit, because the Spirit intercedes for the saints according to the will of God. Our psalm is 104. I'll read the light verse and you read the dark verse. How manifold are Your works, O Lord! In the wisdom You have made them all. The earth is full of Your creatures. Yonder is the sea, great and wide, and it swarms too many to number, living both the old and the great. There go the ships to and fro, and the Leviathan, which You made for the sport of it. You give it to them, they gather it. You open Your hand, and they are filled with good things. You send forth Your Spirit, and they are created. And so You renew the face of the earth. You look at the earth and it trembles. You touch the mountains, and they smoke. May these words of mine please God. I will rejoice in the Lord.
We have a special hymn and a special moment for this group and for this day as a Pentecost day. You see, the first reading is the last reading for today. And so this is organized by our choir and mainly by our choir director. He composed the music for the text of the Pentecost Acts 2. Thank you so much, Mike. And so I invite the choir to come to the front, and Rudy do their reading, yeah?
The day of Pentecost came, and they were all together in one place. Suddenly, a sound like a violent blast of wind came from heaven and filled the whole house where they were sitting. They saw tongues like flames that separated, and one rested on each of them. They were filled with the Holy Spirit and started to speak in other languages as the Spirit gave them the ability to speak. From every nation under heaven to live in Jerusalem. When that sound came, the crowd was dumbfounded because each one heard the disciples speak his own language. Amazed and wondering, they asked, "Don't all these who are speaking come from Galilee? And how does every one of us hear his own language that he was born with?" Others sneered and said, but Peter, standing with the 11, raised his voice and addressed them.
These men are not drunk. turn to darkness and the moon to blood.
Before the coming of the Lord, great and glorious day.
Then everyone who calls on the name of the Lord shall be saved.
Gospel acclamation. Hallelujah.
The gospel is from John, the 15th chapter. When the advocate comes, whom I will send to you from the Father, the Spirit of truth who comes from the Father, he will testify on my behalf. You are also to testify because you have been with me from the beginning. I did not say these things to you from the beginning, because I was with you. But now I am going to him who sent me. Yet none of you asks, where are you going? But because I have said these things to you, sorrow has filled your hearts. Nevertheless, I tell you the truth. It is to your advantage that I go away. For if I do not go away, the advocate will not come to you. But if I go, I will send him to you. And when he comes, he will prove the world wrong about sin and righteousness and judgment. About sin, because they do not believe in me. About righteousness, because I am going to the Father, and you will see me no longer. About judgment, because the ruler of this world has been condemned. I still have many things to say to you, but you cannot hear them now. When the Spirit of truth comes, he will guide you into all the truth. For he will not speak on his own, but he will speak whatever he hears. He will declare to you the things that are to come. He will glorify me, because he will take what is mine and declare it to you. All that the Father has is mine. For this reason I say that he will take what is mine and declare it to you. The Gospel of the Lord.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
Dear Lord, you always hear our prayers before we ask you to give us the right understanding of your word and strengthen us with your Holy Spirit. Amen. Please be seated. Happy Pentecost. I hope that the message that I will bring to you is understandable for all the people, because I see this a lot of people is not from our church here, but from other churches. Please bring our greeting to your church when you come back to your church. And I will try to explain a little bit about Pentecost, what is a good relation to our confirmants or our confirmation situation. Pentecost means 50 days after Easter or after Pascha. As a church, we have a very big celebration today. Without Pentecost, we would not have a Christian church. Jesus' story would be nothing else but a vague and nostalgic remembrance of a happening which has gone with the wind. But this time the wind blew in a very different way. It didn't take the past traces with it, nor blew them away. The wind brought Christ's presence with it. It inspired the disciples, gave them the power to be his witnesses, and so the mission which started to change the whole world began. About this situation, Luke wrote in the Acts of the Apostles, as we heard a few minutes ago. The coming and appearance of the Holy Spirit to the first disciples happened during the Jewish celebration. Pentecost was one of the great pilgrimage feasts like Easter or the Tabernacle Feast. In order to celebrate those feasts, the Jewish people used to visit the main temple in Jerusalem. All the Israelites over 12 years age, as well as all converted persons, were supposed to participate regularly on those celebrations. Pentecost was also known as the Feast of the First Harvest, or better saying, the beginning of the harvest. They celebrated the beginning of the wheat harvest. Whenever they brought their first wheat offerings, the Jewish people thanked God for the harvest, for the fruits of the earth. In this way, the Israelites showed what faith meant to them. God gives not only life, but he supports it with the gifts of the creation. The results of the harvest was seen as a very important part of heaven's creation. Perhaps some big farmers today are not even aware about it, because they are sometimes too busy and concerned about their finances and investments, that they plan in advance how they are going to invest the results of their harvest even before they bring their harvest in. Again, God uses the right moment to show his power and to let everybody know about his mercy. Crowds of people who came from different regions, who spoke different languages, these people hear now God's new promise. The gift of the Holy Spirit is now not only a privilege of kings, priests, and prophets. No, it is a gift to all God's people. Regardless of a gender, age, or social class, God's word is given to all of us. It is written in the book of the Acts of the Apostles that the gospel now was spread across all borders, that new communities were established from Jerusalem to all other places in the world. This can only happen because of the dynamic and the power of the Holy Spirit, who encourages and renews the hearts of all believers. How does the situation in our congregation or the congregation of the visitors here today look like? Is the Spirit still as active as it was in the past? Sometimes we have the impression that there are some signs of indifference and or discouragement. Sometimes I think that there is some happiness and faith conviction lacking. Some days ago when I was talking to some people and having a cup of coffee, we were speaking about the fact that today we don't have the habit anymore to talk about the gospel, about God, about Jesus, as we do it, for example, when we discuss about what is written in a certain book or the journal or about what happened in Edmonton, in Toronto or Ottawa. Oh, Ottawa is a main discussion always. I think that a personal testimony is lacking. A certain expressiveness is lacking in our congregation, in our neighborhood, in our social or in our society. Sometimes there is no interest anymore in speaking about God to other people. How can we explain this situation? Pentecost presents us this question. Is there maybe a deficit of understanding and experience? The text points to the fact that men, women, young, old servants and maids, all of them can be changed into tools of God's Spirit in our world. The question is there such a conscious interest and experience in our congregation, in our neighborhood, or in our church? We can start and ask already the confirmants about it. How do you think that things are going to be in a couple of months? Is a lot of people ask me during the confirmation class here or the congregation, what will happen later? Will you change into tools of God's Spirit in our neighborhood or city? Will you still be able to talk about God or Jesus when you are among your friends? I think this point is the most difficult. Talk with my friends about Jesus. Hey, this guy is not normal. He is talking about God. He's talking about Jesus. It's difficult. I understand. Will you still be able to talk about this? Usually, on our confirmation day, we say with a great conviction that we want to live a life with God. This means to speak about our Lord. This means to talk about the name of God, of His love. The Jewish celebration of Pentecost gives us a proper context to think about this theme, because the Holy Spirit is seen as one of the most important gifts which we as human beings and also as congregation need for our living. A person needs bread to be kept alive, because bread gives his body the needed energy. To ask and to thank for our daily bread means that we recognize that it comes from God. Pentecost reminds us also that we as human beings need God's Word. In His words, we can find the reason and direction for our lives. The same happens to our congregation. Each person has to be willing to be renewed. the spirits of corruption, greed, indifference, and other evils kill life. Pentecost brought something new. It brought the gospel. All people heard it in their own language. The Holy Spirit goes beyond all borders. It takes away all fears and gives us a clear vision. It builds communities. It builds peace. Through the Holy Spirit, we gain our faith through my own power and will. I am not able to believe in Jesus Christ, but the Holy Spirit enlightened me, wrote Martin Luther in the Small Catechism. The Holy Spirit acts during our baptism, in the sermons, during the Holy Communion, and when we read God's words. Pentecost reminds us also that we read not enough our Bibles. They are not supposed to remain dusty in our bookshelves at home. Luther writes, "The Holy Scripture is the seal of the Holy Spirit." The Holy Scripture is the seal of the Holy Spirit. Through this way, the Holy Spirit wants to reach all people and bring them the life which is Christ Jesus. The Holy Spirit was and continues to be the spring of a mission. It is the Holy Spirit doing to convince people through the message of salvation to believe in Jesus Christ. That is why we also need Pentecost. We need God's Spirit like a car which cannot be driven without gas. The miracle of Pentecost is possible for us too, if we are open to receive God's Spirit. That is what is expected from each Christian. Try to ask God to send you His Spirit, so that you are helped to announce His word. You can be sure that He will help you and that He will not abandon you. On the contrary, you will feel better when you start a new day with more happiness, with more courage, and mainly with more peace and love. This is what I wish to you. Amen. And the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, keep guard over your hearts and minds in Jesus Christ. Amen. Please be seated and let us sing the hymn 396, Spirit of Gentleness. Spirit of Gentleness, 396. I present now the confirmants of 2015 of this congregation. Saxon Delilah Petra Hoffman, daughter of Deborah Hoffman. Kevin Christopher Cronin, son of Andreas and Kerstin Cronin. Braden Gregory Schultz and Garrett Thomas Schultz, sons of Walter Holden and Susan Patricia Schultz. We want to hear now their statement.
To me, confirmation is accepting God as a teacher and a father. He will show us how to love, to forgive, and to find peace in ourselves and others. I am confirming that I wish to believe and live in his word, for we are the sheep and he is the shepherd.
Confirmation signifies the acceptance of God in your heart. It is the foundation of our Christian faith, from which point on we need to grow and continue our quest to become a follower of Jesus and his ways. Through these studies in confirmation class, I have learned about our faith, God, and Jesus. I've had my doubts, just as Thomas had with his, but it is an ongoing progress in our daily lives to ask questions and try to understand what our faith in God and Jesus will mean to us. Confirmation is only the first step in a journey through life with God, and I am at this junction of my life, now where I am taking my first step. This step will be followed by many more on the road of life.
Me being confirmed means showing my true faith to God. Over the past 2 years, I have had the opportunity to learn more about the Bible and God. What I now know about my faith will help me through certain decisions that I will have to make in the years to come. I would like to thank Pastor Sigma and Pastor Mike for guiding me along the confirmation.
After attending confirmation classes, I reaffirmed my faith in Jesus. I was like that blind man in the Bible who could see again after Jesus helped him. With the guidance of Jesus, I started concentrating and I think I have become a better person. So what does being confirmed mean to me? It means that I've stayed true to Jesus over these 2 years and that Jesus will always be a part of me in my life.
Let us pray. O Holy Spirit of God, take me as your disciple. Guide me, illuminate me, and sanctify me. Bind my hands that they may do no evil. Cover my eyes that they may see it no more. Sanctify my heart that evil may not dwell within me. You are my God. You are my guide. Whatsoever you forbid me, I will renounce. And whatsoever you command me in your strength, I will do. Lead me then unto the fullness of your truth. Amen. We are going to hear the confirmant's confession of faith with the words of the Apostles' Creed, only the confirmant's. I believe in God.
Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into the dead. On the third day he rose again.
He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of sins, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Amen. You have made public profession of your faith. Do you intend to hold unto this faith and to seek to understand it more fully? Do you intend to remember your baptism as a constant assurance that God has chosen you and that you belong to Him? Do you intend to live your life in harmony with what Jesus Christ revealed of God's will for us, as the Scriptures declare it? Are you willing to work with the people of God, the Church, to do what you honestly believe God wants for His people and His world?
I do, and I ask God to help me.
So let us pray all together, the confirmants and congregation, the prayer as it is in the bulletin. Please kneel. Lord God, we thank you that in our bed you gave us a new quality of life and a new way of living. You have called us to among your people and to be your people. Continue to strengthen us with the power of your Holy Spirit. Father in heaven, for Jesus' sake, stir up in Saxon, Delilah, Petra Hoffman, Kevin, Christopher Cronin, Braddon, Gregory Schultz, and Garrett Thomas Schultz. The gift of your Holy Spirit, confirm their faith, guide their life, empower them in serving, give them patience in suffering, and bring them to everlasting life.
Amen.
Amen. Saxon Delilah Petra Hoffman. Nothing brings me greater happiness than to hear that my children are obeying the truth. 3 John chapter 1. Kevin Christopher Cronin. My dear friends, we are already God's children, though what we will be hasn't yet been seen. But we do know that when Christ returns, we will be like Him, because we will see Him as He truly is. This hope makes us keep ourselves holy, just as Christ is holy. 1 John 3. Braddon Gregory Schultz. Love is kind and patient, never jealous, boastful, proud, or rude. 1 Corinthians 13, verse 4. Schultz, share your plans with the Lord and you will succeed. Proverbs 16.
Holy Spirit,
Confirmation is intended to be a significant stepping stone in your lifelong Christian experience and learning. We know that you will have your questions and your doubts, but we expect that you will be mature enough to recognize that you need to continue to search the scriptures, to associate with believers, and to inquire more fully what it means to know Christ. With intelligence and faith, you will want to assume ever greater responsibilities in the family of God. If you have been chosen and you have been commissioned to be ambassador of Christ in this world, God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit bless, preserve, and keep you now and forevermore. So let us pray. We turn to you with confidence, Lord our God, and give you thanks for our lives. We pray especially for our confirmants. Stay with them with your Holy Spirit and keep them in your love. Give them grace to be a light in the dark world and to be people who radiate peace and goodness. Lead them to meaningful tasks so that their lives may bring joy to themselves and to others. Let them find support and friendship in the church and make our congregation become what you have intended us to be, a community to return to, where we all feel at home and where we may meet you in one another, in the word and in the singing, in prayer and in the sacraments. Amen. A member of our council will give the confirmants a little recordation. Please follow the liturgy as it is in the bulletin.
Through affirmation of baptism, this sister and brothers, by the grace of God, have chosen to commit themselves to sharing all the privileges and responsibilities of a Christian life. Greet your affirmation of faith with joy. We affirm your membership in the Lord's family, and we rejoice in your decision to accept membership in the body of Christ, to live as sons and daughters of the same Heavenly Father, and to be workers with us in the kingdom of God.
You confirmed your baptism. Now you are officially a member of this church. Go. I invite the congregation to sing the Holy Spirit, Root of Life, 399. 399.
Thank you.
Let us be prepared for the Holy Communion. The Lord be with you. Holy Communion is the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, given with bread and wine, instituted by Christ Himself for us to eat and drink, given and shed for you for the forgiveness of sin. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. So let us praise Lord with the hymn, Holy, Holy, Holy Lord. The night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread and gave thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat, this is the body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, and saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, Lamb of God. See the goodness of our Lord. Please be seated. And I wish to explain a little bit. I invite all of you to come to the Holy Communion, but we want to start with the confirmants and their parents. First, the confirmants and their parents, and then it's open for all the congregation. Thank you. follow the last page. The body of our Lord Jesus Christ and his precious blood strengthen and preserve you in his grace. Let us pray. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord's face shine on you with grace and mercy. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace. Amen. Shine, Jesus, shine. 671. 671. Serve the Lord.